we just want to thank Mr. Harrison, our new drama teacher. Before he came to the school last September, us three didn't do sod all. Not a thing. He got us into this, he's a good bloke. Oh, you are, sir. I know he's been offered a job at a better school. Well, good luck to him. Before he came here last September, the teachers had given us up for dead. We were average.
Lillian is average. She opens her book well and likes a warm room.
Gail is stagnant to an earth and fights when cornered. Average.
I don't feel average today. I feel top of the class. Thanks to Sir.
I never thought I'd be doing this. I hated drama. I only took it for a doss about.
Okay, right. Don't forget to keep in character. And Obby, say something.
I will do.
And speak up.
I will do.
What we've been told was told to us by Mr. Harrison.
And although you might not believe it, everything what's said in this is the truth.
But the names and faces haven't been changed.
To protect the innocent.
We're going to take you to Whitemoor High School, a comprehensive school, somewhere in England, and a new teacher is about to arrive.
There's 1,500 kids at Whitemoor, and it's a special priority area.
Which means it's got its fair share of problems.
So you'll have to use your imagination, because there's only three of us, and we have to play a lot of different characters.
And narrators.
You'll have to concentrate.
Oh, yeah. You'll have to concentrate. Title?
Yeah. Oh, and it's called Teachers. Good morning.
Morning!
Morning.
Good morning.
Morning, miss.
Bastards.
Morning, Mrs. Parry.
Stop chewing, girl. Spit it out, not into her hair, into a bin.
Do you call that lying, Claire Dickinson?
No, neither do I.
I know that was the bell, Simon Patterson. The bell is a signal for me to move, and not for any of you.
Mr. Nixon, the new drama teacher. Do you know where Mrs. Paddy's office is?
Up the stairs in the nice part of the school. First left.
He doesn't look much like a teacher. He looks like someone who's come to fix the drains.
I knew in my interview that Whitehall was a school with a bad reputation. I have no drama facilities, but like a sheriff with my brand new degree pinned to my chest, I bounded up to Mrs. Paddy's office. She was busy with Mr. Bass, the deputy head.
I don't believe you're doing that.
I run it. I should do what I like.
After all the work I put in, you're going to turn around and tell me that I'm not Coco. Great. It's a bloody liberty.
Mr. Bass. There's nothing else to say. We need a younger person. I'm sure you'll have a great deal of fun in the chorus.
In the chorus? I want to be seen dead in the chorus!
Such or nothing. Good day, I have another appointment. Mrs. Parry, or should I say Cordelia Parry, B-A-M-E-D, was a huge, attractive woman. She carried herself very well and an awful dress sense and would often mix pink with yellow. She was of a large frame and with a voice to match. Mr. Nixon, G.F. Nixon.
That's her!
Good morning!
Coffee? Please. Mrs. Paddy's office was an office, a cabin of theatre posters. She certainly had more than a passing interest.
Drama! Bare more than a passion. Wonderful. If my all-male production of The Trojan Woman. And this is me, as Ophelia.
Jane de Red was a photo of a much lighter than Mrs. Paddy in an amateur production of Amulets.
The Mikado was a long term, Mr. Nixon.
It must be difficult.
I'm looking for a cocoa.
I knew exactly what she meant.
Mr. Basford, usually takes the lead in our local GNS productions, but I'm afraid he was rather tiresome in last year's production of The Pirates. Ha!
Things. Keep an eye out for the thuggish boys and the tea treating girls. They'll have you for breakfast.
But one thing struck him about Mrs. Parry. She really did care about the kids at Whitehall.
As we walked from my office, that is Mrs. Parry's, I wished Jeff all the luck on his probationary year and took him towards Mr. Bassford's room, home of the timetable. Here we are.
The gigantic timetable was fixed to the wall. It was so colourful, so meticulous. It truly was a work of art, like something from the Vatican. It took a lifetime to make.
The nomenclature is fairly simple. You will be N.I., Mr. Nixon, and drama will be D.R. As you'll be having your lessons in the main hall, drama with you in the main hall would read N.I.D.R.M.H. If you have your lesson, if you have a first year class, it could read N.I.D.R.M.H. Oh, yeah. Can we read one? Fairly simple.
Elementary, Mrs. Paddy.
If you have learning problems at all, Jeff, don't hesitate. Come up if you need to do it right away. I'm always available. And don't forget about the Mikado. I know how much theatre must be in your heart. Give me your big break.
So, I tentatively said yes to a small part in the chorus. And although Mrs. Paddy was disappointed that I didn't want any cocoa, she said I was certainly enjoying my time in Tit-Tapoo.
Excuse me, sir.
Ah! I'm off!
Oh!
Sir and Joss.
Well, where should you be?
Teaching group 3II. And I'm supposed to be in block 4 doing biology, but Mr. Dean's in doing history with 2XX. He says I should be in block 2, but I've been there, sir. And the class is empty. So I've been looking for my class for 40 minutes.
Well, where should you be?
PE in the gym.
Okay, do you have it?
Yes, sir.
Well then, how about you go there now and at least your class will find you?
Right, thanks, sir.
By the way, do you know where the class 7IY is?
When you're a hard nut and 15,
woo!
You always have to give teachers a hard time. It's part of the rules of the game. And when there's a new teacher, you can be even tougher. Our class had seen off 3 teachers in as many weeks.
Bye! Bye. That was Miss Stepbell, who had a breakdown!
Oh my god!
But said she was pregnant.
Then there was a supply teacher who was always crying.
Then there was old Mr. Wilcox, who was dead! So that was a laugh, we'd call him anything.
And now they've sent us a new teacher. A brand new, sparkling, clean, not even out of the box teacher.
They're only going to be in school for 2 more terms. Send them the new bloke, Nixon. He can cut his teeth on 3Y down an II. It's out of the way. If they eat him or burn him alive, we can just forget about him. Ah.
In class 7IY, there was me, Soby, Gail, and Obby. And Obby. Oh, you already know. There was Kevin Mears, who spoke funny. All right, Kevin?
All right, Salty, I've been down at our Malcolm's. He's got a brilliant BMX. And we had a great game of rallycross.
Kevin was 15 going on 3. There was Johnny Froggett, who never wore any decent pair of shoes.
Unlike me. Sally Renshaw.
Vicky.
Marshall. Walter Jones.
Fancy naming a kid Walter.
There was Sally Forshaw, who would sit with every kid in the school, apart from me!
So
Sortie, that's not true.
It is not. Right, who has Benny goods?
I wouldn't ask Benny for what the time was. He's a big mouth and a liar.
Oh, come on, get on with it.
Fine. And Trisha Forshaw, it was known, but it may not be true, to be a bit of a goer.
That's better.
When they send you a new teacher, it was like getting some new foster parents. When Nixon arrived, we were bored and disinterested.
Ooh, it's a bit chilly in here, isn't it? Is this class having a way? Right. Right, you two boys, off the bookcase now. That's for eating, not for sitting. And you two, stop playing table tennis. That'll help a bit. Right, off the table, it's a lot to use. Sit on the chairs now. Now, I'm Mr. Nixon. The entire class burst into laughter. I wasn't sure what they were laughing at. My name is fairly straightforward and I've only got one head. But I turned around and some joker had written on the blackboard a massive pair of genitals. Bollocks is not spelled with an X!
I don't like him.
You haven't even given him a chance.
Why? Do you like him?
No, but you even gave this fella a chance.
He's trying to be too smart.
I hate teachers. He called away You hate being called Olivia?
So what? There's no reason why you should.
Dance break!
Breathing.